the Xtreme Walleye Angler is presented by Go Fish in Ontario. It's catching.
Early September, when you get those cold snaps and the water temperatures go down to about 63, 62, for me, there's a couple things I do. Chase smallmouth, chase walleye, crappie and stuff. But man, I get out the good old hair jig, or bucktail jig, people call it. It's that snap jigging that I'm addicted to. Going out, reading weed lines, putting it out in front of the boat, and just snap. And you say, well, if you catch bass and stuff like that, you're using the walleye rod. It doesn't matter, are you kidding? St. Croix, legend tournament walleye, and I'm gonna fish this little, I got a quarter ounce, because I'm fishing anywhere between 10 and 12 feet of water. It's that last 2 feet of the water column that I'm interested in. Those fish are roaming around. So a little bit heavier weight, like a banana style, black, the chartreuse silhouette. This is more about the reaction, snap, snap. I can cover a lot of water, use the right rod. So legend tournament walleye might catch me a whole abundance of critters on the hair jig. Let's find out. There we go. I think that's Mr. Walleye. Is it Mr. Walleye? It's fighting more like pike, maybe. Is it pike or big walleye? You never know. What are you? Northern or walleye? Nope, Mr. Largemouth. Look at that. Mr. Largemouth on the bucktail. A fat little largemouth too. Coming out for walleyes and getting Mr. Largemouth. Fat little guy, first thing in the morning. Ooh, let's let him go. We're not looking for you, are we? No. But hey, man. Hair jigs in September can be one of the most deadliest ways to catch fish. I'm going to show you how we do it with the tackle, the locations, and hopefully some more and bigger ones just like that. Let's just keep going. Man, when I find the edge of the weeds, it's just like gold. Really, it's just like gold. I use that Garmin, I sit on the edge of the weeds, and I see the sparse stuff first about 2 feet above the bottom with nothing, like sand, then some more sparse. And I can see when the sun comes out each time, the real darkness, the weed comes up 5, 6, 7 feet over about 10 to 12. That's the ticket. That's the ticket. Where those fish are sitting with their nose out, whether it be the largemouth, the pike, or the walleye, they're right on that edge. It's so, so important. Following what your sonar shows you, use the sun, see the dark shadows, put that bucktail up there, and just snap it. But remember, it has to go all the way down, right to the bottom. That's the beauty of the bucktail or the hair jig. You can cover the whole water column. Just eat it up. Eat that hair. Oh, look at that, see? Look at that. That's a gorgeous, gorgeous fish right there. Look at it. Look at that. Sitting on the edge out here. Look at how big, how beautiful. Hey? Big, beautiful walleyes. They get hooked on the hair. Oh, God. That's what I'm looking for right there. That's what I came for. That's what I wanted to catch. And throwing the hair, you can't miss. Let me show you exactly where he's got it here. Hold on, walleye, hold on. I ain't gonna hurt you. I got you on the outside there. Look where he's got that hair jig. Look at that. Tell me he wanted that hair, huh? Oh yeah. Find that hook, right there you are, right there. Hold on. Just a nice, beautiful walleye, eh? From OM Resort, right here. No Piongo, man. You talk about Ontario walleyes, it's amazing. Okay. Oh, you think he was okay? A couple quick snaps, let him go, so you can come here, you can catch him at that resort right there. Opiongo Mountain Resort for walleye, largemouth, smallmouth, you name it, because it is here, boy. Got the hair jig on, catch some more fish. Stick around, we'll be right back.